You know, when you're applying for a job, it's one thing to talk to a prospective employer face to face, but there's a little etiquette you need to follow if you're talking over the phone. Here to tell us what to keep in mind, Randy Wooden with the Goodwill Professional Center. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I guess that's the lost art of the phone message, right?
Yeah, it kind of is. And we all use cell phones, and it's so easy to hit redial when right. you miss a call. But think about from a different perspective. Now you're dealing with employers, mm-hmm. and one of the main gripes I have, frustrations, whatever, when I try to call even one of my professional center clients, maybe to rearrange an appointment or right. whatever, when I call them, here are a few things I don't want to hear.
Okay.
I don't want to hear this person has not set up their voicemail box.
That's a no-no.
Especially if they're a job hunter.
Sure.
The mailbox is full, call back.
Yeah.
Right. But here's another one, and people overlook this. I don't want to get that automated, you've reached 336, blah, blah, blah. I don't want to get that. I want to hear your voice.
That's a good point. Yeah, you want to be personal there.
You do, and another reason for that is, what if I have keyed in the wrong phone number?
Mm-hmm.
I've never heard your voice before, probably.
Right.
I may be calling the wrong number to set up an interview.
True.
And you lose, so that's a bad thing. But let's flip it around. Now, let's say I'm calling, and I'm going to leave a message at a business.
Okay.
Get to the point.
Get Instead of the rambling kind yeah. of 3 minutes of
2 to 3 minutes, and I'm sitting there dying on the, you
right.
know, account. Get to the point. But speak a little slower, like I'm doing now. If your name is difficult to pronounce, pronounce it twice, maybe even spell it. Repeat your phone number. Don't fail to leave a number. Again, mm-hmm. thinking the cell phone life mm-hmm. that we live, they'll just hit redial. They're right. not going to do that.
Right.
So, that, again, that's your first impression a lot of times is when they hear you on that voice.
You hit message. On one of my pet peeves right there when people leave you a message and they say, this is such and such numbers. And you cannot, I've listened to messages several times and you can't make out the phone
number.
And
if I'm an employer, do I really care to listen to them?
You're not
going
to go to that effort. You're exactly right.
You bet, because they haven't built a value. So
speak slowly and clearly. Make sure, and repeating the number is a good thing because sometimes there's a dropout in a call.
Yeah, tell who you are, why you're calling, and if you're following up on a, let's say, an application, same thing. State your name, realize they have a lot of applications, mm-hmm. and here's the position I'm interested in. Respectfully ask that you would consider me and leave my phone number.
Now, sometimes there are phone interviews. It's not just trading messages. That's another thing you need to be aware of.
Yeah, well, it's the same thing. You want to show enthusiasm in your voice. On TV, we can see you, but on a phone, we can only hear you. So your tone of voice is critical. I'd even say dress up a little bit, stand up, have all your notes in front of you, and again, treat it like a real interview. Don't sit back.
Now, why do that? Why do that?
Because
go to that extent.
It's the mindset. It puts you in the frame of mind that I'm a professional and I'm ready to get after it versus kind of laid back, just chilling on the couch.
That's a great point. You talk one way when you're laying on the couch. You talk another way when you're into the moment.
And if you can find a landline, I know they're tough these days, but if you can find a landline, usually the phone signal is stronger than it might be on your cell phone. It sounds clearer, so that might be another tip for you.
Okay, I tell you what, this it seems simple, but all of this, it really can make a difference.
Make the difference, and who knows, one little difference, that could be the plus that gets you the job.
Get you the job, Randy. Always a pleasure. Thank you so much. Great ideas from Randy. If you want to get in touch with him, you can do that by contacting the Goodwill Professional Center, their website, Goodwill Professional Center at goodwillprofessionalcenter.org. However, email is procenter@goodwillnwnc.org. That's for Goodwill of Northwest North Carolina. Or just give them a call, 336-464-0516.